and culture. We all have a different idea of how the world came to be, depending on where we live and the traditions that we grew up on. But nobody can really know, because we weren't there. There are some people, some very smart, some are just parrots, who really believe that they have the answer. And who knows? I mean, maybe one of them is right. But we will never really know. So we gotta hold space for everyone's truth. Speaking of not knowing, and to bring things up to the present day, nobody really knows what it's gonna look like when this pandemic is over. We can assume things, and we can hope who our friends and community are, but we really can't know for sure. We're all experiencing and going through this kind of like this shared traumatic experience together, which, you know, brings some people together, but also pulls some people apart. And we just really can't know what the future holds. I've spoken with several of you who have shared with me some of, you know, your story, and you've said that the pandemic hit at a time where you were just starting deconstructing, or you had just left, you know, a toxic relationship, or you quit a horrible job. So this may have allowed you to kind of like slip out of the communities that you were in without being noticed. So on one hand, you kind of skipped out on some potential drama, but then on the other hand, the loneliness and pain that you may be feeling during this time may feel self-inflicted. And that is a really sucky feeling. It may have you questioning yourself, doubting your doubts, abandoning your self-intuition, and even gaslighting yourself into submission to your past self or like your past habits. Trust me, I get it. But we gotta know where these feelings are coming from and recognize that we're all a little lonely. And to be clear, deconstruction does not always mean conservative Christian to progressive Christian, or evangelical to universalist or agnostic. Deconstruction doesn't ever require you to have an affiliation with the Christian faith. Deconstruction can be done in any faith. Deconstruction doesn't require any religious affiliation at all. It is just a reassessing and reevaluating any of the systems of belief that you were taught or you grew up on. This can be cultural, social, political, you get the idea. It means asking the hard questions that may lead to a dismantling of that belief structure. Your deconstruction doesn't have to look like mine. It won't, because it can't, because we each have our own unique experiences. The way you handle deconstruction or reconstruction doesn't have to look like the way that I handle it. Not everyone needs to shout out from the rooftops about their traumas. Not everybody has to start a podcast reevaluating publicly about their faith. Not everyone has to talk about it as much as I do. Because one, it's natural for me. I enjoy documenting my life in this way. Two, it's healing for me. I like to talk through this and bounce off of other people. And three, I can handle the weight of the responses. Good, bad, even the weight of other people's stories when they reach out to me and tell me about their life and their experiences and their deconstruction and their traumas. I can handle it, but it isn't for everyone. And I just don't want you to feel like your deconstruction or reconstruction needs to look like mine or anyone else's. It won't, because it can't. There is value in the way that you process, and nobody can take that away from you. Thanks for watching. Until next time.